Android Accessibility Suite. What is it? Why isn't it on your phone? And why should you keep it updated? Let's get into it. So first, what is Android Accessibility Suite? It is a set of apps that helps people with disabilities use an Android phone. You can find it in the Google Play Store and it's pre-installed on Android devices. It includes things like TalkBack, which allows people who are visually impaired or blind like me to use their phone non-visually. It also includes Select to Speak, which is similar to TalkBack a little bit, and Accessibility Menu, which shows larger icons for some device settings, and Switch Access, which allows Switch users to use their Android phone, and this is really helpful for people who have mobility challenges. If you're in the know and you work at Google, correct me if I'm wrong, but I also assume that it includes things like display and screen zoom, magnification, and maybe caption and other accessibility features. So why is this app on your phone? The simple answer, which I've already mentioned, is so that people with disabilities can use an Android phone. For me, being visually impaired, I can use TalkBack. I just press and hold the volume up and down and it turns on TalkBack and it just reads everything for me. I can also make things much larger and just easier for me to use. And no, before you ask, you can't uninstall it and you really don't have to. It doesn't do any harm on your phone and you can continue using your phone however you want. Why should you keep it updated? So for those who do use accessibility features and you don't have your app set to automatically update, you do want to keep Android Accessibility Suite up to date. This allows all your accessibility features and settings to also be up to date. It works a little bit differently than the iPhone because on iPhone, the operating system, the iOS version, is tied to the accessibility features. So if one updates, so does the other. Apple can't make any updates or changes or bug fixes to VoiceOver unless they also make an update to the iOS version. Maybe they can, but I've never heard of them doing that. Android, on the other hand, has quite a bit of fragmentation, so there's lots of different devices out there with lots of different skins and lots of different Android versions. So this is why Google developed it so that they can independently update the Android Accessibility Suite so that they can push out updates on accessibility features and settings. And believe me, this is a good thing. If you're using an older Android phone, which for security, I know is probably not a very good idea, but this is not the video for that, you can still have access to some of the newer accessibility features. Of course, there are some caveats. For example, for TalkBack, the newer, sort of newer, multi-finger gestures won't be coming to any device that does not run Android 12 on a certain security update. But there are some newer updates like voice commands and braille input that you can use on older Android versions. And this is because Android Accessibility Suite is not tied to the operating system. Aside from the Android Accessibility Suite, there are other accessibility apps made by Google. There's Google Lookout for people who are visually impaired, and it's basically an OCR and object recognition app. There's Live Transcribe if you're deaf or hard of hearing and you want live transcriptions. There's also Voice Access, where you can control the phone just with your voice. And there's also the new reading mode, which I talk about in this video, which helps you read longer form content. In short, if you don't use accessibility features, you could probably just ignore the app. And if you do, you want to keep this updated. And if you're interested in more technology and accessibility, make sure to subscribe. That's it for this video, and I will see you in the next one.